Hey, what's up? What's up, guys? Thank you for coming to my house. Thank you for coming to my YouTube channel, man. I really appreciate you all. Yeah, EKKI Media one more time, yeah? All about him, all about praise to the Most High God. I'm no pastor, I'm no evangelist. Yeah, but I believe in God because my life is all about him, all about God, people. So I really appreciate you. I really thank you for your love, for your support. Thank you so much. And I pray that God will bless you wherever you were, no matter what is happening, what you're going through in your life. I want to promise you that this best is yet to come. Because for real, I would say I never dreamt, I never thought of myself to be where I am. But by trusting in God, by believing in God, by the grace of God, I'm where I am today. If it wasn't for God, man. If it wasn't for God. If it wasn't for him. I live for him. I breathe because of him. I was no special than all my friends. But God. All right, but God, that's all. Yeah, so welcome back. I did a video last week about trust, and I quoted the scriptures, few scriptures, like, you know, they that trust in God, they're like mountains of iron. I'm not preaching. I just want to encourage somebody. And then I read a scripture that most people don't even know about. It's in the book of Micah, depending where you're from. And these scriptures talks about trust. You know, I'm not saying don't trust people, don't have faith, don't trust in people. But the Bible talks of, you know, when we put our trust like fully, like you don't expect that human beings can disappoint you, heartbreak your, break your heart, you know, let you down. Sometimes when it actually happens, it's really, really, you know, it gets people into depression, it gets people into heartache, it gets people into like big mess. And this scripture was just amazing. This scripture is just amazing. Say, don't trust your friends, your neighbors, even your siblings, because they're all humans. And humans are bound to error, to disappoint you, or let you down. Okay? Say, and what is trust? What is, when we say trust, what is trust really? When you say about trust. You know, the definition basically for trust is it's a belief in reality truth. It's a belief in reality truth. Basically, definition is a real is a belief in reality truth. Reality truth. And you know, Jesus said about the truth. He said, "You shall know the truth, and the truth that you know shall set you free." So even in trust, I always like, with all I've been through in my life, at home, I've seen things when I was a kid that I wasn't supposed to see. My relatives, my aunt, my mom, my dad, my, you know, my cousins. I saw a whole lot of stuff. I was just a kid. I have those memories, you know, things I've seen in ministries, you know. And these are things that when you come to realize, most people get so disappointed, get heartbroken, get depressed, and you hate life because of that. So basically, trust is a belief in the reality, truth, the truth. You know, when you sometimes you believe you don't really know the truth. You just believe because you want to have a doubt, you know. And then it's the ability of truth in the strength of someone, and, you know, like, they're able to do stuff. They will never disappoint you. They will never let you down. But guess what? Human beings, when you... I always, personally, this is my opinion. This is my opinion, for real. You don't have to be like me. You don't have to be like me. But all my life, I've been so disappointed since when I was a kid, you know? I would say something, but I don't want to say them, okay? Because I want to just have some good memories about my mom, my dad, my aunts, and all that. But I saw things, you know, that makes me think that my dad had valid reason to believe that I wasn't his son. Because, you know, I've seen things. I've seen things even when I was growing up. So, And today I just want to continue with that topic about trust, okay? Trust in God. I'm not saying don't believe people, don't trust in people. But as you trust people, always have these, you know, always have some room for disappointment. Personally, I'm human. I've disappointed people. I said I'll do things that I thought I could do, but I'm human and humans are limited, you know? When you make your vows to your spouse, when you get in a relationship, when you get into a job, when you get even going to school, you know, you're guaranteed, you think you're going to get a job, you're going to get all this, that, after you're done with school. But at the end of the day, sometimes it doesn't happen as you thought it would happen. Then what? You know what I'm saying? So I'm just continuing with the topic I had last time. I'm not saying don't trust in the system. Don't have some little faith or trust in people or, you know, whatever is happening in life. But the scripture talks about totally trusting in God. Totally trusting in God. You know, in the book of Proverbs, we say like, trust in God, trust in the Lord with all your might. Do not lean on your own understanding. Do not lean on your own understanding, but trust in God. What do you mean? When, you know, I remember days when you got in relationships. I was, you know, into the things of God, and, you know, you met this person, and, you know, they are not into Christian stuff, and, you know, your people caution you, even your spirit tells you, do not get into it. But because you think you know better than God, you get into a relationship, or you get into a business, you know, you get into a business that eventually, you know, you realize that if you only listen to that still small voice, it would have saved you a lot of heartache. You understand? So in the book of Proverbs, it talks about trust in the Lord and do not lean on your own understanding. Trust me, if I leaned on my own understanding, I think I would still be stuck where I was. Because my understanding used to tell me I cannot go beyond where I was. I cannot go beyond a certain point. I come from this background. I come from, if I trusted in my own understanding, my understanding said it is not possible. You cannot do it. You come from this family. You have this, not this form of education. You know, your families cannot help you because they're also like poor people. And you have no connection. You have no job. You have no this, you have no that, you have no... That was my understanding because of what I grew up with. And then there's this other understanding. You think that you know better than God, you know? You say, I have a master's degree. I have a bachelor's degree. Oh, you know, even in relationships, you know, the Bible says, do not trust in your own understanding. Because I know at some point in life, I got in a relationship that I wasn't supposed to get into, okay? That relationship got me way into crazy things. And trust me, people came, men of God came, sisters and brothers came and told me, please stay out of this. Do not get involved in this relationship. And I promise you, many years later, or many months later, I was walking in the streets of Nairobi, crying, depressed, stressed, hating life, wanting to end my life, just because I thought I knew better than God. Even though in this, I could hear that still small voice telling me I should not, and even people cautioned me. You know what? Some people, I've seen women, I've seen men get into relationships that in future they end up breaking them and destroying them, like completely, emotionally, mentally. I've seen people get into drugs, get into addiction, getting to, you know, I've seen people end up homeless because they got into certain relationship. They were cautioned about it. You know, you should have listened, but you gave your all. You just vulnerable, open up your heart, you stop leaning on God, you stop trusting in God, and you totally, and you eventually end up getting heartbroken, wounded, injured, you hate life, you lose your trust in God. You end up losing your trust. Have you ever been in a place where you feel like you don't even trust God? You don't trust humanity just because you gave your trust to somebody with all your might, with all your strength, with your everything, and then they end up taking advantage of you. I've been there, I've done that, and I have come to learn, you know, it is only God. Because why trust in God? Why should we trust in God? Why should we trust in God? Because God is omniscient. God is omnipotent. God knows all things. God knows the future. God knows the present. He begins the end from the beginning. He begins the end from the beginning. By the time God begins something, he already knows. It's like a manufacturer. You know, when they manufactured this guitar, they didn't just begin. They already knew what they wanted to be. You know what I'm saying? So God is the same way. And you know, mankind took this concept from God. He starts the end from the beginning. That's what somebody said. So when you trust in God, there's a benefit. There's one major benefit that God sometimes will let you get. Listen to this, huh? God sometimes, if you listen and truly trust in God, if you listen and truly trust in God and have a relationship. I've been there and I never listened several times. And I ended up crying, I ended up broken, I ended up so messed up mentally, emotionally, where you wake up, you just don't want to leave. You hate life. And you blame God, but it's not God. He warned you. He gave you that still small voice. He sent people to you. Could be your mom, could be your relatives, could be your friend, but we didn't listen. Because God can use anybody. You know what I'm saying? So when you trust in God and have a relationship with God, because he knows the future. If you try to get in a relationship that God knows, in future, when you settle down, you have children, you get married to this dude or you get married to this woman, it's going to be chaotic in your life. It's going to give you heartache. It's going to break your heart. It's going to disappoint you. It's going to lead you into depression. And this doesn't just apply to relationship. It also applies to career, business deal. It applies to anything in life. You know, the Bible is the scriptures of life. It's like the script. You know, if you're in this IT stuff, we always deal with script. The script is just like a logic of how things should. The Bible is like the script of life to guide you, to warn you of dangers and things, of future, present, and all that's gonna. That is the scriptures. So if you listen to that still small voice, understand the scripture, listen to words of advice. When it comes to trust, you know, when you trust in God, God will preserve you for future pain. God will preserve you for future heartache. God will preserve you for future headache. God will preserve you for future heartbreak. God will preserve you for future anything that will disappoint you. You'd rather you be heartbroken now that you can't get what you want. Let me say that again. You'd rather get you heartbroken now because you can't get that dude that you want or that woman that you want, because he knows the future. He knows you can deal with it now, but in future you might not deal with it because you might have children, because you might have, you know, other things happening in your life, and it will be way too late. And you might be older, you might be old, you know. You'd rather save you future pain in the present. Listen to me, when you trust God and lean upon God with all understanding, he knows the future. So this is what God will do. He will save you a future pain, future heartache, future depression, future, you know, like future burdens. He will save you from all that pain now, because you can handle it now, but you might not handle it in the future. I'm no preacher, I'm just saying. Because I've been there. There's some things I've done in life that I wish I had listened. It was easier to let it go then than to let it go in future. When you already let it go, at the time when you get the signs, it's easier to deal with it. You might want it, but it's not good for you, because in future it might destroy you. It might destroy your mind. It might destroy your heart. It might destroy your faith. It might destroy everything in future. So God would rather save you if you truly trust in God and lean upon God and not upon your own understanding. It don't matter. God would rather save you the future pain now, because it's less pain now than in future. Can you imagine if God saves you from a relationship? You really like this girl and you're in your mid-20s or you're in your early 30s, or this dude you're crazy about, you know. But, you know, you get all the signs, you get all the signals, you get all the flags. It's not going to be good in future. But you disobey. You get warnings, but you disobey. And then in future, think of it. You're in your 40s. You got 3 kids. You know, it's not just going to be you. It's going to be with the kids. It's going to be so many other people involved. It's going to be heartache. It's going to cause a lot of people pain. So because God knows future, he'd rather you deal with it now. Just let it, that relationship, just let that bad, shady business go. Because we living in the days where people like want quick, you know, quick money. You want to make that buck real quick. You get in shady deals, you know. I've seen people doing some shady deals, you know. I had to turn some deals down. I'm like, no, I can't do this, because my conscience, my spirit says no. And then you end up seeing down the line, these people are in prison. You end up losing everything. You end up like in the street. You know, you end up with nothing. I met this one dude in Nairobi. I'm like, dude, you should have just stayed with God. You know, you should have just stayed and not do what you are doing. Making that quick money. Ended up in the street, end up with nothing. So sometimes it's good to not just learn on your own, lean on your own understanding, because your understanding is limited. Trusting in mankind, our understanding is limited, and they're always bound to. I remember this one time in Kenya, I was really still struggling in life, and I was invited by one of these major Christian TV shows to go and give a presentation and give my testimony. And guess who I was sitting next to? I was sitting next to the vice president of Kenya. I was sitting right, Kalonzo Musyoka, the vice president of the Republic of Kenya. I was sitting right next to him. And when he had my testimony and everything that was happening, he called me, gave me his number. And he's like, you know what? Call me next week. I'm going to set up a meeting. We're going to do this. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. I'm going to go there. And guess what happened? I tried to call that number over and over. 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 1 year. I kept the number, never went through. Though he's a government official, if I fully trusted on his word, because at this point I had already learned not to trust fully on what people tell you. You know, they might mean well, but sometimes human beings are limited. Maybe he was busy, maybe he was this, maybe he was that, you know. But if I went with my own understanding, like, oh, he's a vice president of Kenya, he's gonna do this for me, he's gonna do this for me, I would have hated life, I would have been depressed. But because I had learned to lean and trust in God, I was not disappointed. I was not frustrated, because I knew, because I had learned that only God can never let you down. Your parents can let you down. Your relatives can, because I've been let down by all of them. Your pastors can let you down. It's not one time you hear all these scandals happening about ministers and everything, left, right, and center, because they're humans, and humans are limited and bound to fall, bound to make mistakes. But if you trust in God, you will be like Mount Zion. You shall not be moved. You shall not be moved. You shall not be disappointed. I shall not be moved. You shall not be moved. Just like a mountain planted or watery by one side, you shall not be moved. All right, guys. So I have learned to trust in God. Through it all, I have learned to trust in Jesus. I have learned to trust in God. Through it all, I have learned to depend upon His word. Through it all, I have learned to trust in Jesus. I have learned to trust in God. Through it all, I have learned to depend upon His word. Alrighty, guys. Thank you. IKEKI Media, one more time. Thank you for coming to my house. Thank you for visiting my YouTube channel. I don't take you for granted. May God bless you. And remember, I don't mean don't trust people, but put your trust and lean upon God. Lean not on what you understand. Lean not on your own understanding. Don't not lean your trust or put your trust in other things, but put your full trust upon God. And no matter what happens in your life, you will come out a victor. So, IKEKI Media, don't forget, smash that like, share me out, subscribe if it's your first time, guys. Just subscribe and turn on the notification. And my IG is EMIKING on IG. Check me out. May God bless you. One love. Big it up. Yeah, IKEKI Media. God is good, y'all. God is good. God is good.